Good morning, good afternoon and good evening folks and friends. In this video, we will explain software configuration and how to set up the development environment for your application development.
The standard software delivery package from IBAE is a folder which contains two zip archives. The first folder is the standard deliverables folder and the other is the protocol stack library. The protocol stack library is shaped based on the configuration of your device. This library has the necessary APIs required for the specific protocol communication. The standard deliverables folder contains the documents folder, which includes all the necessary user manuals that are needed to help you kickstart your development with the development kit. The cross compiler needed for application development. The UUU tool, which is used for flashing the firmware onto the TCU device, the library and the headers containing APIs needed for the device control. In order to flash the firmware on the device, set up the hardware as shown. Remove the battery and the external power. Place the jumpers on the two pins. Note that the jumpers are needed only during the flashing procedure and should be removed for the regular operation of the device. Now, connect the harness cable. Connect the USB cable. And the input power. Now let's get on to the steps for flashing the firmware onto the device. Open the deliverables folder and navigate to the UUU tool folder and extract the tool. The flashing procedure varies depending on the OS that is being used on the host PC. On Windows, navigate to the UUU tool folder window. Press Shift and right click with the mouse at the same time. Select the Open PowerShell Window Here option. Once PowerShell is open, enter the command as shown to begin the flashing process. The progress of the flashing procedure can be monitored on the progress bar. On Linux, navigate to the UUU tool folder on the terminal window and enter the command as shown to begin the flashing process. The progress of the flashing procedure can be monitored on the progress bar. Once the flashing is successful, remove the external battery if connected and the jumpers. And then power cycle the device. The device would now boot up with the new firmware. Next, we'll look at the TCU demo application configuration. To help you get a quick hands-on experience of the device, the IBAE TCU has a sample demo application. This application uses Node-RED to help you configure the device to collect the telemetry and sensor data and transferring this data to the cloud. To access the Node-RED interface, first let us power on the device and wait for it to boot up. Once the device boots up, using a PC, connect to the TCU's Wi-Fi as shown. The password is provided in the user manual. Open a web browser and enter the IP address and the port number as shown to access the Node-RED interface. You might need to turn off the proxy settings on your PC. The Node-RED interface with a pre-configured Node-RED flow can be seen. A UDP listener node is used for getting the telemetry and sensor data to the Node-RED application. In order to set up a flow to send data to an MQTT broker, drag and drop the MQTT out node as shown from the node palette. Connect the UDP listener port to the MQTT out node. Next, configure the credentials of the MQTT out node by double-clicking on it. In the configuration pane, add a new MQTT broker and then configure the other details as required. Save the changes once done. The required parameters to be collected from the vehicle can also be configured. For the procedure on creating the configuration string, please refer to the TCU Demo Application User Manual. After creating the configuration string, paste it in the inject node and save. Click on Deploy to save all the changes. After this, click on the button on the inject node to enable the configuration. For the MQTT node, on successful connection to the broker, a green checkbox showing the status of the connection will appear beneath the node. Alternatively, data can also be configured and to be sent to any other clouds like IBM Watson Cloud or Azure Cloud by installing and configuring nodes for the same. More details on steps for the same have been provided in the Node-RED user manual in detail.
That brings us to the end of the software configuration and how to set up the development environment for your application development. In case of any difficulties, please get in touch with your sales representative at iWave or shoot us a mail at support.ovd@iwavesystems.com. Thank you.